there's some other things I couldn't mention because the time keeps running out to 10 minutes. Plus, I don't remember them all at the time. But one of the things I was trying to say about mankind seeing smaller and smaller and smaller things, you know, the process of something, all the way back to the, let's say, the beginning of the universe. Let's say they even get that far. Let's say that the beginning of the universe was all protons or electrons or something at some point. Part of my point is they'll never see, because they're seeing smaller and smaller and smaller. They're not backing out from it. They're not backing out to the entire, they're not looking at the big picture. They're trying to go deeper and deeper into things. They're finding quarks and leptons and neutrons and atoms and molecules and protons and electrons and yada yada, etc., etc., etc. But even if they get to that point, they'll still have the question, how did it get there? They'll still never have that answer, because they're trying to go into it. They're trying to see smaller. They're trying to figure out the beginning process, scientifically, logically, blah, 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 blah. And I think if they want the answer, they're going to have to back out from the entire universe. Now, maybe I haven't, maybe I don't. Maybe I've done said it all in the last three videos. Maybe that is the answer. But some of the other things I wanted to throw out there, ideas. The double slit theory, I'd commented, I posted a video response to it before, but like I said, I deleted a lot of videos, and I just found them to be wasteless space, and nobody's listening. Nobody's probably going to listen to any of these, but I'm going to put them out there, and this time I'm going to leave them. I think this will be the last one, unless I come up with some more stuff I forgot, or a bunch of new stuff. I'll jot down the idea of it itself, not the whole entire theory process or nothing, but, and then I'll be able to look at, you know, look at the word itself, and that way I'll be able to iterate on it. I'll be able to theoreticize about it. But the double slit theory, the double slit theory was a, at least as far as I know, that they said that they didn't understand why, when it was being observed, that it seemed to go into a straight line. The theory was, you know, you're throwing like protons or something through a slit, and it ends up, I can't remember exactly how it went. I'd have to go back and see the video, but the fact of the matter is that they're saying that when it's being observed, it changes course, even though the observation of it shouldn't change the course. It does, because that's like saying you open up a door, so that is changing the process, the flow of things. The reason why it does change its course because it's being observed is because it's being observed, and whatever it's being, however it's being observed, is creating a difference, and they need to figure out what that difference is. That's their answer to why it changes its course when it's being observed. It's only logical, so I wanted to throw that out there. I wrote down four little things on here. AIDS, the cure to AIDS, which I had posted a video, but it was a video response to something else, and I ended up adding it later on. And I thought it was a good idea that if they don't know how to cure AIDS, of course they don't, and other type forms of hepatitis, I think that it's simple. I could be wrong. I'm not a doctor or scientist, but I think the answer would lie in where it begins. And I think even AIDS began in the rectum and in the penis, or whatever the case is. I think that with all the bacterias and maybe a code or disease somebody had prior to, or what they ate, the makeup of their body, their DNA structure, whatever the case is, leads to the start of AIDS. I think somewhere in there, which was logical, duh, that there would be the answer. If you want to know the answer, the cure for AIDS, well, there's it. There it is. Start where it starts, where it should start. I mean, it's so as far as I'm gonna go on that, although I got a lot of other things to say about it. Another thing, when I was 19 years old, well, all through my life I kept messing with numbers and stuff, and when I was 19 years old, I ended up working out this calculation, and I never thought that any of the calculations like amounted to anything. But the calculation was, there was a bunch of numbers, and there was a point, I remember that much, like three numbers on each of them, 3.25, I don't know, but the point was, I did 20 of them, it was almost like 1 to 20, but not exactly, and when you crossed each number with the number adjacent, or directly across from it, diagonal, whatever the word I'm looking for, right across from it, when you connected it with that number equaled a specific number, let's say 2, who cares, let's say 20, it equaled 2112, I do remember that much, it equaled 2112. And each number that crossed, every number crossed the other number that it was directly across from, all equaled 2112. And I thought it might be significant. Also, for the fact that I keep seeing people say a lot of things like 2012 and all these predictions and stuff. And I know that Nostradamus worked out a lot of different calculations. Maybe that's where he got a lot of his stuff from, calculations. Anyway, I used to mess with a lot of numbers, and I used to come up with all these calculations, and I never thought they meant anything, and I forgot some of the calculations to some things, but one of the other calculations I worked out, which I don't remember exactly, was like 7 divided into 3, and you come out with an infinite number. When you times it times itself again after the division, and you times that number times the number divided into, that's right, then you should come back out with 7, but you don't. Or no, you should come back, times that times 7, times that number times 7, you should come back out with the number 3, but you don't. You come out with 2.9 infinitely, and there's a point missing. And the best way, a lot of people say, leave the just leave a remainder. That's what I was told in school. Just leave a remainder. Be okay. But it never made sense to me. I was always into math big time, but everything else I really wasn't into. Anyway, I figured out that if you did that, that at the end of the calculation where the infinite loop started, that number added to it. I don't remember if it was after it was times back to try to equal, which would be 2.9 infinitely, or if it was the number itself, and you add that number, like, you plus that number at the end of the infinite loop, where the infinite loop begins or ends. And that was the missing number. And it was like a dominoes. And in my mind, I could see it. It went boom, 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 infinite loop, boom. And then you add that little piece back in, and it's in the calculation. Like I said, it's at the end. Like when you divide 2 into 4, it goes 2 times. And you put 2 on there, and then you come up with 0. That 0 is what you add at the end. That's the answer to the dominoes to get back down, to destroy the infinite loop. So I'm not sure if that's of any good either, but it just seems like it is, especially since I was always told, just put a remainder, and the 10 minutes is up.